What's good, everybody? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of the Celebrity Junk.
As you brothers know, I am in the pro-black community, have been for certain amount of years. I was in the black manosphere, which is not so similar, but very close. But the pro-black community is, you got a lot of historians, and we don't have a lot of brothers in the pro-black community that are like business people for the most part, people who are investors, people who bring development. Most of these people are big time like teachers, similar to Umar, okay? This is not everybody, but most people. And what they like to do all day is drop knowledge. You know, they like to just drop facts, historical data. See, this is what happened here, and this is what's happened there. And, you know, some of them come to Africa and they do that. You know, they go talk to random Africans on the street and try to teach them who they really are. And people are not rude to them, but nobody really cares, okay? Because it's information and data in which, for most people, it has no bearing. You ever meet somebody like that? And they're just like, what's going on, brother? The white man back in 1937, the Lands Grant Act. And it's like, okay, that's nice to know, but you know, I need money today, dude. Like, what opportunity do you have for me today? And they really don't, but they pride themselves of dropping all this knowledge. This is no different for Fresh and Fit and Myron. Myron is a guy on Twitter, formerly Twitter, now known as X. His main job is to drop knowledge on the Jews, okay? He wants everybody to know the real truth about the so-called Jewish community, okay? Many people I know, definitely the Jewish community, would consider this to be anti-Semite material, okay? So he's on here talking about, you know, he's having all these debates on X, which really, for me, I don't understand how it makes sense. But let's just listen to one of these things here, and we're going
to
come back.
No, to take it back. I'm okay with calling you out, Myron. You're a liar, and you hate Jews, and I'd appreciate if you could at least say it openly so it's recorded. Thank you.
Here's the thing, bro. Like, you literally...
Here's
the thing. You yapped for a very long time, right? And you didn't disprove anything that I said. All you did is the typical talking point. You're an anti-Semite. How about this? Can you call me a liar? That's what matters. Again, I'm not going to let these come in and browbeat me and tell me, oh, you're an anti-Semite, as if I'm scared. No. Am I a liar? Answer that. Am I a liar, Alex? Everything I said was absolutely factual. You might not like it because it talks about the unflattering reality when it comes to Jewish control in the United States, but I'm going to say it. I'm not going to down for like you that are going to sit there and call me anti-Semite as if I'm scared of you. I'm going to say
it. Are you?
No, I'm not. I'm a truth teller. Now, if it happens to be anti-Semitic to you because you're a and don't like the truth, that's not my problem. All right? But you're not going to sit here
and intimidate
me. Oh, I want you to say it on camera that you're an anti-Semite. No, am I a liar? Tell me that.
You are. What I already said that.
What did I lie about?
Anyway, Suleiman, because I'm tired of his crying.
So, Suleiman, to address your point.
No, I'm just
exactly.
Tired of your childish.
You can't my point.
Suleiman, to address your
I was too busy texting because people
are complaining about listen, I don't know why you wanted to listen, but I just want to, for everybody in here, this is what they do. They take a victim mindset, don't disprove any of your points, call you an anti-Semite, and hope to write you off. I'm not in it for it no more. Disprove what I said. What did I say that was a lie? That Israel stole the nukes from us? That's the truth. That they run tech. And if you go ahead and look at who runs all these tech companies, it's like, dude. Everything I said was absolutely factual. If you don't like it and you want to call it anti-Semitic because it's the truth, then so be it. That's not my problem. I'm critical of everyone. Jews, blacks, whites, Asians, everybody. So my thing is, I say it like it is. And how are you going to call me an anti-Semite when I'm a true Arab? I'm not a anti-Semite. I'm a truth teller. So off. I'm not going to get browbeat by you liberal fucks.
Now, I've been did a video about how there's a little bit of a beef, it seems, between Fresh and Myron. And you know, Fresh... it's not a person that's into geopolitics. Fresh is a bona fide trick. He wants to clap white women's cheeks. He doesn't care about anything that makes sense, in my honest opinion. You know how I feel like intellectually. I think Fresh is a little behind. Okay, this is not me being mean. He just listen to Fresh talk. Okay, it seems like he just, you know, he eats kibbles and bits for breakfast. That's Fresh. But Fresh is going to point out something to Myron that pisses him off.
The only one.
Common sense here, man.
Yeah, look. Okay.
There are Jews that are part of 100% part of the ruling class, 100,000%.
Yeah.
It's just I don't agree that they're the majority. I don't agree.
I have a question. Pointing out who's behind the.
Here we go.
Hold on. This is very important.
Shut up. He started talking, and then Myron went, oh, here we go. Meaning they've already discussed what they're about to discuss, and Myron's already dismissing. Now listen.
Pointing out who's behind the scenes pulling strings, what does that do? Someone please tell me. What does that do?
I guess it just.
I'm going to make you a target.
No, 100%.
I get fucked up. 100%. What does that do for the public?
Yeah.
Well, a lot of people probably didn't know that just now, and now they know.
What are they going to do behind
with it? What are they going to do with it? Education is important, bro.
To do what?
It's like a freshman. Not going to have this discussion with you, bro.
I'm just saying.
You're always like, bro, why are you
there's
name
no
them?
Point calling out people.
All right, we'll go back to YouTube.
You
then.
Cannot
so
defeat.
So Fresh can feel safe. Let's just go back to YouTube.
And what is he saying here? He's saying, listen, man, why does it matter that these people you're talking about in which you just can't beat them? Why is it like, why are we always talking about them? And Myron thinks he's dropping knowledge. And the reality is that nobody cares. Okay. Some people care, but let me tell you why many people don't. Because if you can't really beat them and get organized and do what they're doing, it doesn't matter. And this is what I figured out a long time ago when we were talking about black women all the time as black men. We would sit back in the black manosphere, a lot of us as brothers, we would be pointing out basically as black men, you know, what we felt sisters were doing, the Democratic Party was doing. And, you know, it was just a whole bunch of dropping facts, how single sisters were. You had certain brothers talking about the obesity rate, the single motherhood rate, why women need men and all of that. And listen, you know, brothers was coming with receipts, but that doesn't change the structure of things. If you don't own the businesses in your community, if you can't pay people, if you can't establish institutions and systems that protect your people, you can talk about that until the chickens come home, the roosters, or the cows come home, or whoever else you want. It's not gonna change anything. And the only thing that you're gonna do about, you know, talking about your opinions about certain groups or certain theories is you're gonna find yourself demonetized, or you're gonna find yourself in a lot of trouble. Instead of complaining about the Jews or complaining about white supremacy or complaining about what's going on, you got the opportunity to organize yourself. That's the same thing that we saw what happened with the manosphere. Mainly the white manosphere, if I can say that. The white manosphere guys were really big on the men's rights activism. Shout out to Anthony Johnson, because, you know, that's what 21 Convention was doing. They're doing some really good things. The problem with certain guys in the sphere, I'm not gonna say everybody, but then it became a problem between the men. Same thing that brought down the black manosphere. It became a problem between the men. It wasn't even the women as to why a lot of us couldn't, you know, come together and do a lot of work. It became, we couldn't get along. And some of the guys are no longer on YouTube. Some of the guys are doing completely different things. We wasted a completely great opportunity, and I'll be honest, we let a lot of guys down. Okay, we did. We lost a good opportunity because we couldn't get it together. And so many people wanted to see us win, and so many folks wanted to see men's rights wins. And I would argue that men's rights is nowhere closer to getting something done than it was 10 years ago, because it became all about talking about women and what women are doing and pointing out facts and dropping knowledge versus, okay, as men, how can we help each other in the economy? As men, how can we help each other in voting, in business? What can we do to get into these industries? That's what the Jewish people do. They help their people. They don't sit around and try to worry about talking all day. You know, they're like, look, where's the opportunity for us to do X, Y, and Z? Okay, well then we're gonna put our work in, put our time into X, Y, and Z. Most Asians are the same way. A lot of blacks are that way. The ones that are successful. Then you change policy when you have resources. But Myron doesn't do that. Myron sits on X all day with no money invested in anything, and is on Twitter space trying to be a revolutionary on Twitter spaces, getting demonetized on every platform, removing his financial opportunities that he could do if he really felt like he needed to establish himself, which he ain't gonna spend no money with nobody,
and now you're just dumb. The only person you're hurting is yourself. Meanwhile, I've been preach, making $1 million off of you. O'Shea Duke Jackson is definitely about to get a new Jerry Curl wig off you. I mean, I don't know how much camera equipment I'm about to buy this month off of Myron's silly ass. I just don't know. I might buy all kind of batteries. I might buy a new lighting system. I'm about to buy a whole bunch of stuff simply because he's not focused on the right thing. And a lot of us got to start focusing on the right thing. You got to get your mind off of just trying to blame groups. Okay. That's going to take too much time. I don't even talk about so much of like, oh, we need to look at the whites. We need to look at certain blacks. We need to look at this and that. I'm looking at what can like-minded people do, and then what can we do to get people to help us grow, and then we can get our money this way, like everybody else does. There is no group that can be better than everybody's human. We all have opportunity. Why not take it for your own advancement, you know? And again, I just, that's why I really can't get down with a lot of that blaming black women for everything anymore kind of stuff, or blaming black men. No, a lot of us just blow opportunities to do things, $1 million opportunities. Some of y'all are more lucky than others. Some of you guys, let me just tell you this. I live in Uganda, okay? Some of you brothers and sisters, you guys actually live in big cities, New York City, Washington, D.C. Some of you live in the Chicagoland area, Los Angeles, the Bay Area. Do you know how much more chances you have in life simply because you live in one of those cities? How easier your life will be? Like, how many more opportunities, even if you mess up, than somebody who grows up in Kampala, Uganda? You got junior colleges. You got universities. You have state universities. Do you know how many times I messed up? And because I live in America, I was still able to go to medical school at 34. If you don't get it right by like 19 in most countries, you can't become a doctor. America is just a chance for complete opportunities. Complete. You can fail your business 7, 8, 9 times, bankruptcy, and get it right. That's America. And we're talking about somebody else. Okay, it might be true, but you can't stop it. You can try to get it organized and do what you need to do, but losers sit around all day and complain about somebody else. I just can't do that. I can't. And you don't get no point for that. You sound dumb, okay? That's anybody. So guys, what do you think? It's your boy O'Shea Duke Jackson back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. I appreciate you for all you do. Just heard the bell. We're out.